Praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most gracious, the most merciful, the one who created mankind, the one who bestowed his ni'mah, his bounties on human beings. He gave us life, he kept us healthy, and he made earth to be very comfortable for us to walk in, and he made heaven to become canopies to protect us from the sunshine, the heat of the sun. We glorify his name and we declare there is no God except him, and we declare our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is his messenger and the servant and the beloved. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our prayers.
Amen.
Ibadallah, as I mentioned last week, we are in the great month. It's a month of Hurum. Ashhuru Hurum. There are 4 months in Islamic calendar. They are sacred months. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made them. Zulqa'dah, Zulhijjah, Muharram, Rajab. These 4 months are important to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anybody who work hard in this month, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will double reward you. Because Allah made it like that. It is from his jad. That's what he wants. He made this month to become more than the other month. Allah loved this month. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is encouraging us to do more ibadah. Any good thing you do in this month, Allah will reward you abundantly. May Allah give us courage to do more.
Amen.
May Allah accept our prayers.
Amen.
We are in the great month. Tomorrow will be Ashura. A lot of people been hearing Ashura, Ashura. What is Ashura? Ashura is the 10th of Muharram. Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he migrated from Mecca to Medina, he met Jews celebrating. In other hadiths, they say they are fasting. He met them fasting when it comes to 10th of Muharram. Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the most beloved, the most calm person, wonderful person, he approached the Jew and asked them, why are you fasting 10th of Muharram? And they said, because this is the day Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from the wrath of Fir'aun. This is the day Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala killed Fir'aun. When Musa went to Egypt and take his people, while traveling, they are going to Palestine, then Pharaoh got the information that he chased them. When he chased them, it came to a point where they are seeing the people of Musa. People of Musa, when they turn back, they have seen that Fir'aun is coming closer to them. Kala ashabu Musa inna lamudrakun. They tell Musa, Musa, you are taking us, we are comfortably. Now you said you want to save us. Now you take us, we get to a place, there's no way we can move again. And the Fir'aun and his soldiers are coming. They tell Musa, Musa, inna lamudrakun. Musa said, Kala kalla inna ma'i rabbi sayadin. They will never get us. I have my Lord, and my Lord will protect me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make wahi to Musa alayhi salam, and adrib bi asaak al bahra fa falaka fa kana kullu firqin ka tawd al azim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked Musa to take his stick and beat the water. When he struck the water and the water split, Allahu Akbar, and every part has become like mountain, and they get the chance to run. When they went, people of Pharaoh came with the Pharaoh. When they enter in the water, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala block in their front. When they turn back, is also blocked, and then they perish in that water. So that day was 10th of Muharram. That's why Jews are fasting or celebrating, thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for what Allah did to them. And then Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when they told him that, Prophet Muhammad said, "Nanu awla bi Musa." We Muslimin are more closer to Musa than you. In other hadith, Prophet Muhammad said, "Musa is my brother." So we have to do more. And then Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when it come next year, when next year meet me, I am alive, inshallah, I'm gonna fast 9th. I will start my fasting 9th. That's what Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. He didn't say we will not fast Ashura. He said he will start it from knife, that's it. And it will continue. That is why some people who know today is the Thursday, they fasted, and tomorrow is the day. Wallahi, anybody who wants more reward, you should fast. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, we should continue. We shouldn't be like you. We have to contradict them in ibadah for them to know that we are doing ibadah because of Allah. And the point is, when people of Musa left Egypt, they left fear of their lives, not because of their religion. They left with Musa fearing of their life, not because of their religion. That's why after Musa saved them, Allah said, وَجَاوَزْنَا بِبَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ الْبَحْرَ فَأَتَوْا عَلَىٰ كَوْمٍ يَعْقُفُونَ عَلَىٰ أَصْنَامٍ لَهُمْ فَكَالُوا يَا مُوسَىٰ اِجْعَلْ لَنَا إِلَٰهًا كَمَا لَهُمْ آلِهَا. How can they say that after Musa saved them, when they get to a point, they saw some people are worshipping an idol, and they approach Musa and say, Musa, can you get us one idol so that we can worship him? Allahu Akbar. لَوْ كَانُوا يَخَافُونَ دِينِهِمْ لَمَا فَعَلُوا ذَلِكَ. If they run because of their religion, they wouldn't have done that. Because they don't know what they are doing. Musa came and saved them. Musa is going to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to show him what to tell them to do. But they don't know. So they ask Musa, they say, Musa, set up an idol for us to worship. Musa said, Innakum qawmun taj'alun. You are ignorant people. After I save you, didn't you see any man who have mind, who have good heart? What happened when we get to Barumalia, when you get to that sea, and you see the miracle that happened, that Allah gave me, are you still thinking of any other God, not my God? That's what Musa asked them. This is clear evidence, clear miracle. This sea